Freight train, going so fast. Freight train, going so fast. Just don't tell them what train I'm on. They won't know what route I've gone. Was a mean old farmer, a cruel old engineer, low down conductor, way back train from here. Just don't tell them what train we're on. They won't know what.
I'm Matthew DiRigo. I'm the vice president of DiRigo Brothers Company of New York. I work with my two brothers and run a full-line fresh fruit and vegetable distribution company. We are located in the Hunts Point Market here in the Bronx, a place that has been here since 1967. There are 50 other companies like ourselves here that make up the New York wholesale fresh fruit and vegetable market. We came from Boston. My grandfather emigrated to Boston in the early 1900s, and in the 20s, our original founding company was established up in Boston. We were wholesalers there, and still are. I have cousins that run a business there. I have another group of cousins that started out in California, the Salinas Valley area, growing fresh fruits, fresh vegetables, actually. Starting with my great uncle that moved out in 1925. So there's three separate DiRigo companies. One's a growing company in California, one is a wholesale distributor company in Boston, and then there's our company here in New York that's a wholesale distribution company. And we're all cousins and we all work together quite closely. And well, one of the earliest, what I would call pioneering genius moves, my great uncle was in California. He was growing 28 acres of broccoli out there. And his brother, my grandfather, was in Boston selling fruits and vegetables. And they basically did an experimental freight car. They filled up a freight car of broccoli, and then in the middle of it, they put this big pillar of ice. It's called bunker ice. And it was akin to a very large beach cooler, basically. You have the big thing in the middle and your sodas and everything around. Well, this was a big freight car full of broccoli with a big bunker ice thing in the middle. Kept it cold 8 days across the country. Nobody knew if it was going to work. It was a total experiment. The freight car arrived in Boston in a timely manner. My grandfather unloaded it, sold it, and they made a profit. And that was the first transcontinental shipment of fresh produce by rail. This idea that this could actually work, that we could grow things in California and transport them by rail to the east where all the people were, was something that was, you know, it was space age. It was brand new. It was never thought of. I mean, the produce business is a very seat of the pants, gray area, wheel and deal business, because Mother Nature, you never know what you're going to get out of Mother Nature on your, when your crop is going to come off, how good it's going to be, how much of it is going to be there. And you pre-sell these crops and you just keep your fingers crossed to find out how well you guessed. And depending to what degree you've guessed wrong or right, you create these shortages and overages in crops, and markets are fluctuating and dynamic and crazy. The vegetable broccoli rabe is a vegetable that our company has developed over the decades, starting back in the 1930s. We actually farmed it and sold it as wild mustard for probably close to two decades. But in the planting and replanting and cultivating of the product, we actually changed its look and changed its taste and changed everything about it to the point where we completely renamed it, and we renamed it Broccoli Rabe back in the 40s. And from that point on, we've been selling something called Andy Boy Broccoli Rabe that most people think is something that came from seeds from Italy, really? From the old country. It was a wild growing plant in the hills of San Jose called wild mustard. And we made it our own. I think it's almost a necessity to grow your business. Staying the same size is, someone's catching you. I think you have to keep growing. You have to keep experimenting and keep trying to get better at what you do, and you keep trying to do different things from what you do. This whole market is a huge job growth center. It's imperative that our market is rebuilt. Right now we are in a 40-year-old market that is just although a noble beast for 40 years and has done the job beautifully, we need to get together with the city and with ourselves and rebuild this market, get it back to be the state of the art. It's a market that was designed in the 50s and it's 2006. So we need to get some new thinking, some new warehousing ideas, some new transportation ideas, some new refrigeration ideas. SoBro is ideally situated to help us to become a philosophical partner with us and a real live partner with us in getting the word out, getting the word out to the government, to the mayor's office, to the deputy mayor's office, to the local politicians, the borough president, basically telling our story and understanding our story and seeing that the need is there and that there's a lot of jobs that can be created if we get this market rebuilt.